What's going on, you guys? CJ Hawk 85 Gamer here, and today I'm going to be playing WCW Nitro for the PlayStation 1 that came out like around, I believe, either January or February of 1998. And I'm going to be honest, this is not one of my favorite games at all. Like, I've seen worse games than this. Alright, I gotta show you the rants of these 16 guys.
You know, brother, you think you got what it takes to beat Hollywood Hogan? Watch ya climb in the ring and try out the largest arms in the world, Hollywood style.
If you wanna wrestle an inch more Ric Flair, you gotta be able to walk that aisle and style and profile. Woo!
You really think you're ready for the Stinger? You really think you're ready for the Scorpion Deathlock? You think you're ready for a fatal encounter?
This is why they call me the total package. Do you have a pain threshold to withstand the torture rack? Let's find out.
Hello, here's Alex Wright. When your high-flying wrestling action vault and spinning sidekick with top turnbuckle dropkick, dann nehmt mich und der Sieg ist euch sicher, ich verspreche euch!
Oh yeah! Watch the flying elbow drop off the top rope! Not only beat people 1, 2, 3, but I hurt them real bad!
It only takes one of 1,000 holds to defeat you. If you think you're man enough for the challenge, step in the ring.
Alístense, porque ustedes saben, cuando entren al ring con Eddie Guerrero, les voy a dar lo mejor de lo que yo tengo.
You better be ready to wrestle, because you know, when you get in the ring with Eddie Guerrero, it's going to be high-flying and exciting.
Hey, anytime you feel froggy, man, I'll slap on the Buzz Killer and rip your shoulder right out of the socket, Wolfpack style!
Hey, monkey boy! Like there's a choice here? Good God! Pick the man with the plan. Pick D-D-P!
Hey, all you suckers out there! You wanna play the game? You wanna play with the big boys? Put your finger on the button, cause when you go down 110th Street, it's gonna be on like neck bone, sucker!
This is Booker T from Harlem Heat, hardcore OG brother from 110th Street. If any of you punks got the guts to step up to the plate, push the button.
Yo, Chico, you selected Scott Hall? Get ready for a wild ride on the outside.
Hey there! How'd you like to get power bombed? Come on, pick me. I'm begging you, pick me. Please pick me.
You think you got the courage to step in the ring? I think you're gonna wind up with a snap neck from the chokeslam.
Technical wrestler, high flyer, brawler, it don't matter what you consider yourself to be. When you're in the ring with the Crippler, you're a loser.
Sheesh. Chris Benoit really telling it like it is, right? Okay, now I'm going to put in the code for all the wrestlers to be online. Alright, we got Eric Bischoff in the game, Mean Gene Okerlund, Chris Jericho, Disco Inferno, Bobby the Brain Heenan, Miss Elizabeth, Sonny Ono, the Ultimo Dragon, Conan, Kimberly, Medusa, oh, her first game. And this is Jacqueline's first game before she was in the Attitude game. Lord Steven Regal, Jimmy Hart, Rey Mysterio Jr., Steve Mongol McMichaels, old school Hulkster, I think it was Larry or Gary Anderson or something. Stinger, Grayling, the alien Tony Schiavone, Macho Man Randy Savage, old school. Whitey the Snowman, Buzz the bee, Ecto the, oh my god, Eddie May, Santa Claus, Bones, the Frankensteiner, oh there you go, T-Rex, Ivan the Bear. Okay, who are these bums? Probably it's the people that Jumbo, John, Bush, Flyboy, Tony the Rod, Superfan, that's weird. Brian, Steve, Mike, Dude Man, Uncle Monkey, Don, Eddie the Wire, okay. Uncle Monkey. Okay, I'm gonna pick Lex Luger first. I'm gonna pick the main 16 people. And let's see who am I gonna wrestle. Let's have Ivan the Bear. I gotta see this. Lex Luger is wrestling a bear. Right here on Nitro. But yeah, I'm gonna be playing 16 guys in this game. The main 16 guys, not the unlocked people. But. Ooh, the NWO arena. Here we go. Powerbomb. Yeah. All right, Luger. I played this game the other day, and I pretty much remember the moves. And for some reason, I remember the finishing moves as well. It's been an awful long time. Like I said before, it's not one of my favorite games of all time, but I've seen way worse games than this. This game's kind of frustrating sometimes. It's like, I don't know. Oh, atomic drop right onto the groin. For the atomic drop or the bear. I did it again. That's funny. Hip tossing a bear. That would have torture rack. Ivan the bear. We're gonna torture this big ass bear. Oh god, I'm getting suplexed by a bear. Oh, atomic drop. Now we're gonna rack the bear. Come on, Luger, let's rack that bear. Here it comes. Lex Luger is giving Ivan the bear the torture rack. And the bear gave up, or he doesn't know how to give up. We just torture racked a bear. Oh, man. That's funny.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Gene Okerlund. I'd like to welcome you to
can't believe I torture racked the bear. Also, I'm going to be doing random arenas in this game, to be honest. And alright, let's pick Diamond Dallas Page. He'll be fighting his ex-wife, Kimberly. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's a special event. Alright, BG Darkwind. DDP's gonna be fighting his ex-wife Kimberly on Nitro. Something should be up for grabs though. I can't think. Alright, here we go. This bitch of an ex-wife is pile driving her ex-husband. I'm gonna powerbomb this bitch. I wonder what ever happened to Kimberly. Just like you dump your ex-wife. We're gonna do it again. Oh! In real life, she get hurt in real life. This. Come on. That's not realistic. She doesn't just get up immediately. She would have been like, ow, my back! Oh, my elbow! She would have done that. Powerbomb on the mat. Oh, look at this. Oh! Tilt toward drop on the back. On the floor. Now, I always preferred the N64 WCW games. I thought Mayhem was good, but I also like WCW and NWO World Tour and Revenge. Those were really good games on the N64. I want to do a review of those one of these days. Of course, some of the old school WWF games as well. If you're wondering, do I still play wrestling games on PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4? Yes, I do. I pretty much almost collect them all. I almost have almost every wrestling game now. Not every single one. But, God, I'm getting powerbombed by his ex-wife. Oh God, I'm getting killed by Kimberly. I think she used to be the leader of the Nitro girls. I'm gonna give her the Diamond Cutter where she'll never see it coming. Oh, that was fake looking. Pile drive that woman. Break her neck. I know it sounds horrible, but I wonder whose bar it is for, oh shit. What? Yeah! Bang! Just like old times, he's dead. Oh yeah, Diamond Cutter, you never saw it coming there, bitch. Self high five. Bang! Don't want to yell because, just not in a mood tonight or something. Oh man. We went through two matches already. So we got 14 to go. That's what I'm gonna do. Is 16 matches and we're down two of them. And we got 14 to go. Alright, let's see who am I gonna pick. Picking Ric Flair, and we're gonna settle an old school rivalry that will be settled once and for all. Eric Bischoff, you are gonna worship at the feet of the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Woo! You've been a jerk throughout the WCW run, but this is gonna be settled once and for all. Oh, kicking the nuts. Yeah. Come on, Ric Flair. We're gonna give Bischoff a wrestling lesson of a lifetime. Since Bischoff tried to starve your family to death. That was a rotten thing to do. Trying to starve Ric Flair's family to death. Even him. Like, come on, Bish. Like, what was Bischoff thinking back in 98? I mean, yeah, Flair had no choice but to go back. But boy, Ric Flair really dropped the pipe bomb on him when he came back. Alright, now I'm getting my ass kicked. Justice is not being served yet. Ric Flair's gonna be... Bischoff is gonna be Ric Flair's bitch. Bob driver breaking his neck. How do you like that, Eric? I almost run away. Ooh, squish! Kick break. Now, the figure four leg lock. Woo! There we go. Flair won. Gave Eric Bischoff like a little bitch. Right here on Nitro. What a fitting place to do it, too. Okay. I'm not going to do a tag team match either. No tag team. Sorry, Teddy Long, if you're watching this, no tag team matches. Alright, let's see who the next victim's gonna be. Let's... Cobra, Virgil, Uncle Monkey. What a dumb name. Who calls themselves Uncle Monkey. So who's Scott Hall gonna beat? Oh, wait. Let's see. Tony the Rod Flyboy? Tony the Rod. Let's go with him. We're gonna take care of Uncle Monkey later on when I feel like it. I'm sorry, but that is the dumbest name for a wrestling name or for a production manager or something. Or the person that's making this crappy game. Uncle Monkey. Who calls themselves Uncle Monkey? What does that even mean? Uncle Monkey is the stupidest name ever. Alright, I gotta get serious. Yeah, Fall Away Slam by Scott Hall. Was dropped him like a yesterday's newspaper. Look, threw him over. We're fighting in a rec room. Look at this arena. I know I'm totally ignoring, you know, what we're fighting at, but oh my god, this is a ginormous rec room. I mean, oh my god. Look at this. Nice little office. The stereo. You have Windows 95, a computer, AOL dial-up. Yeah, I remember those days. You got a ping pong table. We were wrestling in a pool. On a pool table. Oh crap. Now we're gonna give you the wild ride on the outside. Tony the Rod. Get my ass kicked by Tony the Rod. Oh! He got hit by the invisible security gate. Yeah, I said that. The invisible security gate. Liz. It's invisible. See? This is ridiculous. What a ridiculous arena for a wrestling game. It was one of the hottest shows in 97 and 98. And one of the arenas you want to have in this game is a rec room. Should we give him another Outsider's Edge? All depends. Come on, Scott Hall. Get my ass kicked. No, I'm just gonna pin him. Just get it over with. I already gave him the outside edge. Look at this. Camera's flashing on those walls. This arena is ridiculous. Look at this. Look at the size of the room. Looks ginormous. And Tony the Rod and Scott Hall almost look like midgets in that room. It's stupid, honestly. Like, who does that? Oh my god. Alright, let's continue. Let's see what other wacky arenas we're going to be. I'm going to pick Kevin Nash. And I am going to select this guy. I don't care what his name is. I can't pronounce it, so I'm not even going to pronounce this bum's name. Who knows what he's doing nowadays? The Reminator? Rio. And we're in a beehive's nest. Why are we in a beehive's nest? Oh my god. Oh my god. How stupider could it get? A beehive ring, beehive ropes, and we're surrounded by bees. Ow! They're enjoying the action on Nitro. They have their own little Nitro arena, some bee wrestling. In a beehive's nest. This is ridiculous. Oh my god, we shrunk the wrestlers. To beat a beehive like this, even in the rec room. Scott Hall and that other guy, I forget his name, I don't care. They got shrunk too. Come on, Nash. Bottle driver. Oh yeah, we're gonna throw him right in the bees. Oh no, oh no. Oh, I got thrown in the bees. Probably got stung in the ass or something, I don't know. Throw him right in the bees. I hope Ryu got his ass stung. Alright, now we're gonna give him the jackknife powerbomb.
Taking that beating. It's the powerbomb!
This is a sit-down powerbomb, that's what it is. They call it the special powerbomb for some reason in this game. Sweet! Big sexy Kevin Nash wins it. I can't believe I had to choose Kevin Nash and then a random arena they selected was a beehive nest.
I'd like to welcome you to WCW.
We were fighting in a beehive. How touching. Alright, I am going to pick next. I'm going to pick Hollywood Hogan last. So I'm going to pick Chris Benoit. And, oh, I got an idea. He's going to be wrestling. The Crippler Crossface is not in the game, by the way. I totally remember that. I'm gonna pick the Ghost, Ecto. So Benoit's gonna be wrestling a Ghost, the Reaper, on Nitro. The same Reaper that took his soul back in 2007. Oh my god! In a graveyard! How appropriate! Benoit and Ecto are fighting in the graveyard. Oh my god, I have seen it all. The German suplex, the Ghost. That is the whiff of air. Ecto. People call it the whiff of air, and that's a Ghost. And Benoit power driving that Ghost, Ecto. But yeah, unfortunately in this game, there is no Crippler Crossface in the game. I haven't checked. Unfortunately, there's not. His finisher is the diving headbutt. And it's true. Oh god. I got picked up and slammed by Ecto the Ghost. Threw his ass to the graveyard. Where he belongs. How appropriate to have his own little arena. This is ridiculous, honestly. Chris Benoit and Ecto fighting in the graveyard. Oh my god, this is like messed up. German suplex and the Ghost. Alright, here we go. Flying headbutt. Oh yeah, I knocked down Ecto with my head. Getting more head concussions. And have a brain of a 90-year-old man going insane. Chris Benoit, which is fantastic. That is ridiculous. Oh my god.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. All right. I'm Gene Okerlund, and I'd like to welcome you to WCW Nitro.
All right, let's see who I'm going to pick. I'm going to pick Six, aka 123 Kid, Shaw Waltman, X-Pac, whatever. Should I pick Mongo? Nah. Tony Schiavone, Annie May, Dweeble, Flyboy, Superfan. Let's pick him. Pick Superfan. Probably he's not a fan anymore because he's kicking himself in the ass saying, why the hell is WCW out of business today? I was a super fan of it. Oh my god, are you kidding me? We're in a circus. Oh my god, this is ridiculous. Six and Superfan are fighting in a circus. What the heck is this? Oh my god. Oh my god, what's next? What is next? Oh, look at this. Probably Six is gonna grab one of those bars and do a high risk maneuver. Whip between the ropes to the floor.
Pile driver.
Pile driver. All right. This game is ridiculous. I've pretty much seen it all, almost. What's next? What could possibly be next in this game? I mean, a circus? Oh yeah, Buzzkiller! Love that move. Rip that arm right out of the socket. Wolfpack style. A freaking circus! Oh my god. Let's see, who am I going to pick next, and who's going to be the next victim? I'm going to pick Alex Wright. Who's going to be the next victim? Flush? Yeah, let's go in. The Daz Wonder Kid, Alex Wright, takes on NWO member Fush. And we're fighting in the rec room again. Oh my god, again, we're fighting in the rec room. Hip toss by Alex Wright. Look at this. Powerbomb by Alex Wright, the Daz Wonder Kid. That's a nice little hip toss. Like, seriously. I can't take this game seriously, honestly. It's bad enough that it's not a good game the way it functions. Even though I'm playing pretty good, but this game's annoying still. But these arenas are ridiculous! Hmm. Like, this is a rec room. German suplex. And yes, those of you that are wondering, Alex Wright's finisher is the German suplex. Yeah. Lame, isn't it? I'm surprised the Steiner brothers are not in this game. I know they'd be on the N64 version in Thunder. I know they were on WCW versus NWO World Tour. Alright, let's see who I'm going to pick next. Let's pick the Giant, aka Big Show, and he is going to be taking on. Let's see who I can ruin next. Bush again? This guy? No. Mike? Dude, man. Uncle Monkey? Should we go with Uncle Monkey? Let's go with Uncle Monkey. The Giant, aka Big Show, versus Uncle Monkey on Monday Nitro. Ah, we're fighting on Nitro! Cool. And a drop kick by Uncle Monkey. Can you believe that? I'm trying to say this, who names himself Uncle Monkey? That is the dumbest name I ever heard in my life. Uncle Monkey. Strangling the hell out of Uncle Monkey. This is just one step further for the choke slam. And now I'm almost getting my ass kicked by Uncle Monkey. Yeah, throw him like a bad habit. There we go. How you like that, Uncle Monkey? With a horrible name like that. Uncle Monkey. Grinding the shit out of him. Oh, great. Now Uncle Monkey's kicking my ass. Pile driver on Uncle Monkey's head. And now we're gonna choke slam Uncle Monkey right in the center of that ring. Choke slam Uncle Monkey. Oh, now he wants to buy some time. Come on. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. I don't even like this guy. Strangle Uncle Monkey. Honestly, that is a stupid name, honestly. Calls himself Uncle Monkey. What does that mean? What does it mean? Alright. Come on, Uncle Monkey. I'm gonna choke slam you. It's coming. Got me, kid. That's alright. We're gonna get him. Powerbomb! Get up, Uncle Monkey. Ah, there it is. Choke slam. Goodbye. Adios. What the heck is that? Is he doing the Cobra? Oh my god. It's supposed to be his taunt for the choke slam, but looks like he's doing the Cobra. So that's where Santino Morella got it from.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Gene Okerlund, and I'd like to welcome you to WCW.
I'm planning on doing a WWE 2K16 2K showcase mode on one of my favorite wrestlers of all time, Stone Cold Steve Austin 2K showcase. I'm looking forward to that game. I am super pumped. I'm going to be doing a 2K15 2K showcase. I know I uploaded it like a couple months ago, but due to copyright claims by WWE that I was showing WWE footage, I'm going to be editing a lot of the stuff out. Yeah, so for those of you that are wondering why did I delete the footage, that's the reason why. So I apologize if I deleted that. All right, let's see who the next victim is. Yeah, Jumbo, whatever the hell his name is. I don't even care. Who cares? The name's stupid. And I am Sting, by the way. And we're fighting in the Beehive again! This is the second time! This is ridiculous! Scorpion death drop on the ring, on the Beehive, on that little honey nest where they had the Nitro logo. Honestly, this is ridiculous. Stinger. The man they call Sting. I've always liked the pro Sting. You know, I'm glad he came back a couple weeks ago. I was very bummed that he was not at SummerSlam at all. But at least they made up for it. Give him an offer you can't refuse at Night of Champions. I really hope he wins the WWE World Heavyweight title. That would be freaking awesome. Honestly, I just don't see Seth Rollins winning back-to-back at Night of Champions. He may somehow, someway beat Cena and then lose to Sting. This is the message for you, Seth Rollins. You seeing this, Seth Rollins? That's going to be you. I made Jumbo as an example. Who's that? Production guy try to save the day. Well, he's too late. He couldn't save him on time. Now, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Gene Okerlund, and I'd like to welcome you to WCW Nitro.
All right, let's see who I'm gonna pick next. What a wacky shit we could do. I guess I'm gonna pick Booker T. And I am going to pick. I'm going to pick the T-Rex. Booker T's going to be coming for that T-Rex. He's warning him. He's coming for him. And he's going to get him. What? Booker T versus the T-Rex at Slam-Booey. Booker to Slam-Booey. Slam-Booey. I'm sorry, but that one commentator was doing a cough at it was, I forget his name. And he had an event coming up called Slamboree, but he said it so funny. He said, Slamboree! It was on that show called The Main Event. It was WCW, The Main Event. He used the SBR 2010. Forget, yeah, it was WCW, Reaper, new WCW, I think. I think that's what it's called. Oh, wow. It's been a while I've watched CAW wrestling. I only watch AWF and DIW and Call All-Stars. Yeah, I destroyed the T-Rex. Oops, destroy that T-Rex, sucker! You dig that, sucker? Destroyed him at the Slamboree pay-per-view. That's a corny Slamboree arena, by the way.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Gene
Okerlund. Okay,
like
moving on.
WCW Nitro.
Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. This game is like... I don't even like this game, but I'm playing pretty good at this game, though. Surprisingly. Like, I always find a way to make things good. But trust me, it's not worth the buy. Don. He's wrestling Don. Stevie Ray's gonna be wrestling Don on Nitro. Where is it gonna be taking place? Oh God, are you kidding me? In a beehive's nest again. Oh my God. I hope this is the last match. I'm thinking about changing the arenas after this instead of doing random arenas. This is ridiculous. We're always getting the beehive's nest. Throw him right to the beehives. I like that, Don. Don, 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 Don. Don. What is that? Wild driver. Round his head. Pile driver Don's head. Oh God, who's this guy? One of the guys in the suits? Steve Ray's got a big surprise. Oh, I thought it'd be Jacqueline or Booker T. But I got Sonny Ono instead. I know Steve Ray's pretty good friends with Sonny Ono. This is ridiculous. And every time they have a surprising attack, the game moves slow. It's ridiculous. Yeah, every time you press the select button and you want people to interfere and help you out, the game moves slow. That's one of the problems as well. Though I haven't really played the tag team matches in this game, but I know it kind of moves slow. That's why I've been told that it moves slow as hell. Alright. And then when it's one-on-one, then it moves normal. See? Normal pace. Of how they made the game at that time, in 97. Right. Let's get my ribs getting damaged in this game. I want to see you right. Right. I don't want to see Stevie Ray job to Dawn. That would suck. Oh yeah, scissors kicked by Stevie Ray. Here we go. Stevie Ray wins this match. We could all dig that, suckers.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. All right. I'm Gene Okerlund, I'd like to welcome you to WCW Nitro.
Let's see who's next. But first, I'm just going to change the arenas. Sold out. Just put the WCW arena. Because fighting in a beehive's nest, that's ridiculous. Even the rec room or a circus or whatever else they have. I know they got a disco arena, but don't even get me started with that. Always getting beehive nest. Let's see who the next victim's gonna be. Flyboy? Should we pick him? Yeah, let's pick him. And I'm Dean Malenko, the Iceman. The man of 1,000 holds. But according to Chris Jericho, at that time today, he had more than 1,000 holds. He's got 4 more holds than Malenko. That was a great gimmick back in 98. Hold number 1, armbar. Hold number 2, headlock. Hold number 3, chinlock. Number 4, armbar. that was great. Driver on by Malenko. Was getting ass kicked by Flyboy. The Flyboy. All he does is fly. He's flying right now.
Taking a beating.
He's becoming a beatdown boy. Nice spine buster. Look like Triple H does that too. Texas Cobra Leaf. He's tapping out and he's done. And Malenko wins. Who's the next victim? I'm gonna pick the Macho Madness. Ooh, yeah! Who's gonna step into the ring against the Macho Madness? This guy? Maybe the Wire, John Flush, Superman? Dude, man. Gonna step into the ring with the Macho Man this year. Alright. Alright, dude, man. You're stepping in the ring with the Macho Man this. Oh, yeah. Dig it.
Powerbomb.
Nice little powerbomb. There we go, throw him over between the ropes to the floor. Madness is on the loose, brothers. I think this is the outfit that Macho Man was wearing like around February or March of 97. Before he joined the NWO, I think. Was he in the NWO before? Like, I know Macho Man was in the NWO at Super Brawl 7. Hell, he was.
Macho Man is insane! It's a surprise attack!
Oh, here it comes. Uncle Monkey. You know what? The Macho Man is going to send his ex-wife, Elizabeth, here. Come on, Elizabeth, be useful. Macho Man has taught you well.
Are you good?
Oh yeah.
Facebuster. We're on that Uncle Monkey jump. Okay. Belly to belly on Elizabeth. I'm gonna take her to do that. I'll drive her by Elizabeth. Oh, great. Uncle Monkey's kicking my ass. Now I don't even like Uncle Monkey even more. There we go. Trying to break Doom Man's neck. Oh yeah. Look at this. Oh, nice move. That was a brilliant move. Alright, here we go. Elbow drop. He'll do it one more time. Elbow drop on the Doom Man. He can do it while people are standing or people laying down. That's the Macho Madness way. And to be honest, all seriousness, I miss Macho Man Randy Savage. Every wrestling fan misses him. I will always miss him.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Gene Okerlund, and I'd like to welcome you to WCW.
All right. Let's see. I'm going to pick Eddie Guerrero. And I'm going to pick... Mike. That's it. Eddie Guerrero is taking on Mike. Alright, look at the size of Mike. He's a big guy. Nice. That was beautiful by Eddie Guerrero. Nice. Oh god. Now I'm gonna make sure that Mike does not kick my ass. He'll lie, cheat, and steal his way to victory. And this is another guy that I also miss as well. Yeah, in 2 months, will be the 10th anniversary of the death of Eddie Guerrero. I realize that, too. I can't believe it's been almost 10 years. We're getting really close to 10 years. I can't believe it.
Taking a beating.
All right, Eddie. Do it for all the Guerrero fans out there that still miss you to this day. I know it's been 10 years, but you know what? We all miss you. We all love you, Eddie. Oh, God. Who's this guy? Oh, yeah. Dean Malenko is helping out Eddie Guerrero. This is a 2 out of 4 members of the Radicals. That was a brilliant name for a stable when they brought in Chris Benoit, Eddie Guerrero, Perry Saturn, and Dean Malenko out of WCW to WWF. That was really awesome. 4 guys from WCW came to the WWF. But to be honest, that's where they lost their backbone. They were the backbone of the company too. Some could disagree that they almost killed the business. No, they didn't. All right, Guerrero, let's take care of Mike and take him down for good. pin him for the 1-2-3 guaranteed victory for Eddie Guerrero. Leg drop by Eddie Guerrero. One more, and then we're going to get a good angle of doing the frog splash. There you go. We're going to cheat the win. Guerrero style. I hope Eddie Guerrero is in 2K16. I would like to have him in the game. Oh, yeah. Oh, he missed. He missed the frog splash. That sucks. There we go. Now we're gonna do that frog splash. A little froggy, and then 1-2-3. Eddie Guerrero wins it. Viva la Raza! All right, last but not least, even though I'm disappointed in this guy, but I do forgive him. I wish he was on 2K16, and after I've been seeing the roster reveal as of late, something is telling me maybe there was going to be a 2K showcase mode for Hulk Hogan as well. There could have been, and it would have been awesome. But if they didn't have anything planned for it, okay, I understand. But if they did have plans, and then all of a sudden it was taken away from us without us knowing it, that's ridiculous. All right, so who's going to be the victim that's going to be wrestling Hollywood Hulk Hogan, brother? Did you hear last week he wants to run for vice president with Donald Trump? That was ridiculous. All right, Steve or Brian? S&B Security, there you go. Brian from S&B Security. I know that doesn't make any sense, but I don't care. Steve and Brian Security, there you go. Hollywood Hulk Hogan's gonna make sure that Brian pays hard times. It looks like one of Hogan's lawyers or something that couldn't get the job done, brother. Bomb, yeah. Just dumped him like he dumped his warriors and shit. Oh man. By the way, I'm just letting everybody know this is my last match for the evening. I don't think I could take any more of this game. Honestly, the game's ridiculous. It's stiff as hell. When four people are in the match, then it slows up the game. And then after the interferences, then it goes back to normal one-on-one match. I do think that, you know, when we do a tag team match, it's slow. I would not recommend this game at all. I'm just only playing it because there's a 20th anniversary going on with WCW Monday Nitro being on the air 20 years ago on TNT. Their debut episode was September 4th, 1995 on a Monday in the Mall of America. And Hogan was in the main event against Big Bubba. And it was so Pasta Mania. What kind of garbage was that? Pasta Mania. Who's gonna beat Big Bro Bubba tonight? You are, Hogan! Oh, stupid shit. That was beyond corny Hulk Hogan back then. Honestly, he was super corny. You think John Cena was super corny and corny today? Oh my god. Hogan was beyond corny back then. So I destroyed Ryan from S&B Security. And that is going to wrap it up, folks. So, fans, I want to thank you for joining us. I'm sorry I haven't made a video in a month. And I am back, and I will be making more video gaming videos. Next, I'm going to be doing 2K15 2K Showcase mode. So stay tuned for that. And I will see you fans later.